Hello guys, I'm back with another episode. Here in this episode, I'll tell you about the database, the migrations, the models, all the things, how we can use all the things in Laravel 8. So I'll start with how we can connect a database as we are using this Docker and SQL integrated in Laravel 8. I'll tell you how we can link that database to the SQL application and tell you how to create migrations. Before that, I'll tell you what are migrations, how to create migrations, and after creating how to run a migrations and how to create tables using migrations so that you can create database tables using migrations itself. And then I'll tell about models, how we can link this table and models so that we can access the data in the database in the controllers later. So I'll tell you about all those things, database, migrations and models. So stay tuned for the next part of the video.
So in the previous video, I have told you about routing. So this is the root file which we discussed earlier. As I said, about database, migrations and models. So first, I have explained you in the directory structure where the migrations will be and what are these. You see, these are three migrations. These are users table, password resets table and create failed jobs table. So before explaining about these tables even, first I will show you something. If you go to this docker compose.yml, because we are using this docker setup, if you see, this is the example app, and if you further open, there are some things running here. This is the one which we need now. This is MySQL, it's running on port 3306. So we can see the database there. If we go to the terminal and see, we can see the database there. So first let me show you this. So here in this database, in this docker.docker-compose.yml file, you see this is MySQL and it's taking MySQL 8.0, it's taking this 3306 port and all this database password, database name, username, this is all taken from this ENV file. As I said here, this is the ENV file. Here we have this database connection, database host, database port, example app, root with no password. So it's taking all this. So now, as I said, it's connected to this database. So let me first open this example app CLI. So it should open MySQL. I type MySQL, so you're showing this. So I'll just run show databases. It has few databases, but we need to only use this example app. So it says database change. That means we are in this example app. So I'll tell show tables. You see, there are no tables because we have not run any migrations yet. If you see in the migrations, we have three tables, but we cannot see them in those database because we haven't run any migrations for that. So if you see this open and see this migrations table, you'll see this schema create with users table as users. It says ID, string, timestamp. That means you can see you'll have this here, name, email verified at, password. These are all the basic things which a user table has. And if you see create password resets, it says email token created at. And this is just to keep track of the jobs it's run. These are the three default migrations given by Laravel. So if we go to this here, this is our thing. So I run sale app, so it's running, and you can also see this example app. So I just created one more here. So I'm here, I go to cd example app, and here I'll run the php artisan migrate, but we might not run php artisan migrate because we are using sale. So we need to run this sale artisan migrate. Before that, I have make this alias as sale, or else you need to manually type .vendor/something like that. Let me show you that in Laravel documentation. You see, you have to run this .vendor/bin/sale for every time we use sale. We need to run this. So instead of that, if I make this alias, so I can just run this just as sale. or else I need to do this and then do artisan migrate or whatever command I need to run. I need to run this always. So I just set this alias, so I just can run sail instead of this command. Okay, you see these are tables are also created. You can see here three tables are created. So if I go now into this and see, I'll just run again the show tables, and you can see there are three tables: users, password resets, failed jobs, and there is also a table for migration. So that we will see later. So if I describe this this users, you see this ID, name, email, verified ID, password, remember token, created it and updated it. You can see all these are coming from the migration file which I just created. We have not created, but I just opened this. So this is a migration file for users. So it says ID, name, email, email verified ID, password, remember token and timestamps. And if you create this timestamp, it will automatically create these two folders, these two columns for you, created it and updated it. You can see all these things are coming here. So this is a migration. So that is the basic process. First we need to create a migration and then run this artisan migrate. So that it will create a table for us and then we can access the table. After that we can create this model. But the model is already there because it's defined by Laravel by default. So it created this migrations and models. But the ideal thing what we'll do is we'll just create the migration and then run that migration so that table will be created. And later we can create the model when we are accessing the table in our application. So that's the process. Now I just showed you what Laravel created. So now here I'll create a new migration. I'll create a new migration and run that migration, create some database fields like this, and I will show you how to create that model here. So let me do that. So to create a new migration, we can manually copy this file, change this and create, or you can create a new file and write all this. But as I said, Laravel has a beautiful CLI. We can do anything using this CLI. We can create anything. So I will open this again. So here I'll say sail. It should actually use PHP artisan make migration. I'll say sail artisan make. See the syntax here: create users table, create password resets table, create failed jobs table. So I'll also follow the same pattern. I'll say PHP artisan make migrate, create test table. Or I'll just need to test this. So I'll run this, and ideally it should create a new file here in this migrations folder. Let me see this after it's completed. It says created migration. So let me open this file. You can see there is a new file here, create test table. So basically it creates an ID and timestamp. That means ID means, as I said, the primary key. For every table we need to have a primary key, that is the ID, and timestamps. I already said it created that and updated the timestamps. So I'll add few more fields here. As you see, it has users table, like it has name, email. I just add some random things here. Or table string, and I'll say column one. I'll say this is column one, and I'll create one more thing, one more column. I'll say that column two. So we can, instead of calling this string, I'll call it as text. I'll call this as text, and there are so many other things which we can use here. As you see here, it has string, timestamp and remember token, but there are so many things which we can use. You see some other table, it says text, long text, we have big increment. There's so many fields. Like if you go into the Laravel documentation and read about migrations, let me just pull that up for you. You can see these are all the available types we can use. From it's sorted in alphabetical order. You can see from big increments, big integer, binary, boolean, char, dead time. All these are all the available things. Here I'll just use this text and string. So you are free to use any of these. There are so many things you can use. Also UUID directly. So I'll create one more field for UUID. So I'll just copy and I'll say UUID, and I'll say it's not token, Okay, I'm creating some other table. I'm creating password resets. Okay, I'll go to this create table. I'll just copy this and I'll create column 3 and I'll say here GUID. Okay, for now let us create these 3 columns, run this migration and see what's happening. So I'll go into this thing again, and again I will do PHP artisan migrate, I mean sail artisan migrate. You can see it's saying migrating and migrated. So I'll just go into this database again. I will again use this describe users. I mean I'll tell to show tables. You can see there are one more table added test here. So I'll describe that test. You can see ID column 1, column 2, column 3 created it and updated it, and you can see ID is begint. And if I use column 1, I have used what you have used for column 1. I have used string, so it's created a varchar, and for column 2 I have used text. For text it's created text, and for column 3 it's created char of 36. For column 3 I used UID because it has some characters UID. So these are all the things. This is how we can create a table here. So I have created a new table. This is the migration file it automatically creates. The command is sail artisan migrate, I mean to migrate things, but to create a migration, sail artisan make migration and the name of the migration. This is just a convention, you can create whatever you want. Here it says create, and the end it should say table, and the middle thing you can do the table name. And also it's just a convention, you can create even something without that, like this. It will create that something migration, that's not a problem. You don't need to give actually, you don't need to give exactly the same way, but it's better if you follow some convention. So that is the convention followed in Laravel. You see it says created migration something, and if you go you can see created something. This also works the same, but if you then you need to write this create this command, this functions which you have here, create and up and down. This I also forgot to mention, this down, this down is used like if you want to drop a table, you can directly down this each so that's how we can create migrations. So now so there are some cases. So there are some cases where you have created a table, and then if you need to add one more column, like you know you are working through an application. Initially you decided you will have only these 3 fields: string, text, and UID for column 1, column 2, and column 3. But later you found you might need another column for this, one more column. So you need to add column 4. For that, you shouldn't end this migration. You shouldn't come here and add one more thing like column 4 and run that. That is not recommended because you should see these migrations as a version control for your database. Like just like how you do git, you will commit, you will push, you pull that changes, make a new change, may again commit. You can see each change will be there in a commit or a push. So here, if you want to add a new, I mean if you want to add a new column to this table test, first you create a new migration for that. You need to create a new migration just as you will create a new commit for any change. So I'll create make migration update test table. So it says created migration update test table. So I'll go into that table now. See, if I go into this update test table, you can see this is created a migration. So here I need to create a few things in the up, and here I need to write the things for creating a new column. As you see here, it says schema create. Okay, you should see this. It says schema create, but while updating you won't do this. I'll just copy this to show here. I'll say update test table. Instead of doing schema create, I'll say schema table. because I already had that table. So instead of creating, I'll just call this table schema table. I'll add new column. I'll just remove all this and just I'll add one thing here. I'll just say table dot integer. We haven't added integer before, so I'll say integer and I'll say column 4. And also you need to make sure you have this schema and blueprint. It will automatically have because we are creating it from the CLI, but you need to know what is happening. Like it has an up command, up function, and down function. I didn't mention about down. So what happens in this down is, so we have created the migration, but when we want to roll back, as I said, this is just like a version control for database. As you see, you have rollbacks in Git. So what you see is here in this down function, it drops. You see, it drops the table. You see there is a function called drop table. So if you drop this migration, if you roll back this migration, you can then this down function will execute and it will drop the database. So that's how we have two functions. One is up and one is down. This up works when we run PHP partition migrate, and this down works when we explicitly want to down this migration. So this is I'm here in the test table. So if I run this migrations again, you should ideally see if we do all things correct, this new column called column 4. So let's check that. So I need to run again PHP partition sale partition migrate. It says migrating something. Okay, we also created that something that is also migrated, and to also update this test table. So if I go into the database again and just say show tables. You see this column 4 is here, column 4 and int. So that's how you can create a new column, like while you are, as I said, like while you are in the application, if you are in need for a new column, you can do this. You can create a new migration. Just make sure you are using table here instead of create. Everything else will be the same. If you create this, it will have this create, and if you update this, you will just have this table and it will be the table name. So that's how you can update, or you can add a new column to the existing table using migrations, and that's also seen in this table. So next, and also you see here it says this something is also migrated, but in the data, and if you see these tables, we haven't seen that something. That's because we haven't written anything in this something. If you write a, there's nothing, this up function, so that's why it's not created in table. So if we open and create this create function and write something here, that will be created a new table. Or if you write some update things like this, that will update that table. So we haven't written anything, so it didn't create anything. So now we can also drop tables. As I said, we can do this down to drop tables, but we can also explicitly write separate migration to drop the tables. So what you'll do is, so this is already migrated, so I'll create a new migration to drop some table, or we can also rename. First I'll show you how to rename some tables and then create, and then tell you to drop that. So first I'll go to this terminal. I need to create a new migration rename test table. So it will create a new migration for me. It says created migration. So I'll go into this migration. It says rename test table. So here I'll write schema. So it says, you can see there are so many things here. As I'm using PHP Storm IDE, it automatically suggests all the available methods. I'll use the method or property, whatever you call, rename. And here it takes two parameters, as it says from and to. The from is what you want to change, and the to is what is the final result after changing. So I want to change this test table. The table name is test. I want to change it to test2. That's it. So I'll just save this. And as usual, I'll run this PHP partition migrate here. So it will run the migration and create me that. It will change that table name test to test2 ideally. Let us see. So it says migrating and migrated. So let us go into our SQL and I'll say show I will say show tables. You see, it's changed to test2, and if I do describe, it will show the same fields which I had for the test. You see all these things, column 1, 2, 3 and 4. So this way we can rename a table. You just need to use this rename. And same for drop, if you want to drop a table, you will use this drop and you will just tell table 2 and it will drop that. But you cannot do directly here. You need to create new migration. As I said, it's like a version control. You need to do migration for every change you do. And then you won't do this many times. You won't, as I'm testing here, we are doing a lot of files for each and everything. But in a real world scenario, they will auto, you will already define all the table structure and then you will come to the project. But I'm telling the example, so I'm creating just something whatever I want. So I want to tell you the example of drop, but you understand, right? So we can just create drop and do this test, it will run. So I'm not doing that because I need to create a new migration, run that and all. I have shown you that many times. Okay, so I've restored this rename this table, the rename thing. So this is how you can create migrations, and these are the database tables. So one final thing in this, so one final thing left in this video is about this models. You can see user. Similarly, you can create, as I said, if you name the database as, so I create the database name called test and rename to test2. But if I create a database called tests, so I'll just tell you, I'll just show you that. So as I see, yeah, as I said in the earlier in the directory structure, as I said when I'm explaining this directory structure, there is a convention. Like if you create a database name of say users, then you can create a model user.php, it will automatically link. But I have created test, so if I create test.php, it won't link. I need to explicitly specify the table name. You see here, create users, and here in this users model, we haven't specified any table name. But here for this test, not test, test2, I have to specify that model name, table name in the model. So the models can also be created using this CLI. I'll just show you this command, say make model, just as we say make model, make migration. We can also do make model. I'll say test2, it should create me test2. I said if you want to follow the conventions, you should create the table as tests and you can, and the model as test. And I'll tell you one more thing here. Here we're manually creating, manually means one by one. First we're creating the table and then creating the model. You can also create this model and migration at once. I'll show you after this. So it says model created successfully. So it says test2. So here I have to say protected table equal to, I have to say test2, that is our table name. So here we have to explicitly specify this. If you don't want to give that as this, see, you see it will know where it has that it will know where it has that table name, because when we don't do that, we need to create this table name. And we can also, you see there's so many things in this user. This fillable is when we are, I'll tell you when we are into controllers and inserting data in the database, I'll tell you in that section what is this fillable. But I'll explain here a little bit. This fillable means like when you are mass inserting, you can directly insert to a model directly. Can it says here user. And if you go to some controller, we have some controller here, right? I have created some test controller here or test controller here. So you can directly, what you can do is there is a create method user, and we can directly create. So you can pass all the things which the database, which we can pass all the columns here. We can pass as an array, and that array might contain all the things which you have in this user table. You can do like this. So to do like this, if we are creating users like this way, we need to have this fillable in this user. That means only these things can be filled when we are creating one we want to create in this way. There is also other way, like we'll just initialize the user instead of creating all the things at a time. We'll just do one thing at a time, like user, like ID equal to something like that, and then we'll only update $user of what we have, email, something. We can do all this. If you are doing like this, we don't need to use that fillable. And if you are using in this way, like if you use a static method create on this user model, then we need to use that fillable. It will only fill the tables, fill the values which has fillable. And if you give some other thing, it will throw an error. Actually, it's called mass assignment. For mass assignment, we use this this type of things, and you can also do this manually for whatever fields you want. So I'll tell you in deep about these things while inserting your database. I'm just saying these models. I'm telling you about these things. What are these things? And you can see these attributes are mass assignable, and these attributes should be hidden for arrays. As you see, these two things are related to that. And this is like, if you want to, you can see this is very descriptive. If you want to cast that to native types, date time, email UFID, it's automatic. It created a field and it has date time. So for that things we can use, and we can make many more changes. Not only this, and not only having this, but there are also so many relationships, like eloquent relationships. That is separate. I'll make a separate video on eloquent relationships. That means we can interact with two tables using these models here. There are so many relationships, like eloquent ORM, one to one, one to many. There are so many relationships that all we can define here in this model itself. And as I said, in the controls, you can import them anywhere. Like if you use here, use, it will be in app, and by default it should be in user in Laravel previous versions, but it has a model folder. You have to do this models and then do this, what is it called, user, or you can do the same for test. If you go here and create T and tab and press tab, it should automatically create. That means it's working correctly. See, I'm just pressing T and I will press the tab. So not even pressing the tab, the IDE found that there is a table 2. So then that means you are doing it correct. So this is how we can import, and then we can use this. So that's about databases. Initially, I told you I started with this config composer YML. As you are using this Docker and it's running in 3306 port, I opened the database. There are no tables, and I see here it's connected to the database tables in this env file. I opened this, there's a table, this, and there is this table. And then we ran php artisan migrate, that is seal artisan migrate, so it created the tables. And then I told you how to create a new table, update a table, rename a table. You can also drop table. I've also shown you all the available things. Like I've just shown you here string, text, but there are so many things. Here you can see all the available things. I told you about this. So that's about connecting to the database, creating tables, creating models. And I also forgot one thing. As I said, I'll tell you to create migration model at a time. I'll just show you that. So to do that, I'll create a model. I said PHP addition make model. So I also need to follow the convention here. It's better if you follow the conventions while doing these things. Like I will say, like I want to create admins, something like that. Admins, as you see, admins. So if I create this is an option, if I give # and I create let's say migration, it will also create me a migration for this with the table name of admin. You see admins and admin users and user. So you see it migration created successfully. You see this in the models, you see admins, and here in the migrations you see this create admin ID and timestamps. So that's how we can create this models with migrations. But Laravel is not suggesting this thing. They're not suggesting it. Used to be earlier, it used to be even the documentation earlier, but now with latest versions, they are not, they are trying to deprecate or remove this thing. So if you go to the latest documentation, you won't see this. So that's how you can create new tables, update new columns to the table, rename the table, drop a table, and create models with that specific table. So this is all about database, tables, migrations, and models. The previous video I covered about routes,
and here I covered about models. In the later video, I'll cover about views. I will say model, view, controller. Lab is a model, view, controller thing. So first I will cover, first I said about routes, like that is the main thing. And then the models I told here, covered here. And then in the next video, I'll cover about views. And after that video, I'll cover about controllers. So stay tuned for all our next videos. Hope you like the video, guys. If you like it, please consider subscribing to the channel. I'll be continuing this series, Laravel from Scratch. There are so many episodes coming up. So if you like this, please support me by subscribing to this channel and sharing with your friends who might feel this video helpful. So see you in the next video. Bye bye.